So I've been avoiding RWBY Volume 8 content. I'm sure you guys have noticed. I figured it was best to leave it alone for a while. Take a break from the nonsense. Now I'm feeling recharged and ready to break down some of this stuff. When you all read the title of this video, I'm sure you guys were thinking, oh yeah, RWBY and Yang had that talk. I forgot about that scene. No, I'm not psychic. I didn't read your minds. I just know a forgettable scene when I see one. I really wanted to break down this interaction because I've been complaining for years that Yang and RWBY don't have meaningful conversations anymore. They don't talk. The last time they talked sister to sister was back in Volume 3. So yeah, I am very interested in this scene. Let's break it down and see what the writers gave us. Here we go. In Volume 8, Chapter 11, things are very much fraught for our heroes. Ironwood has given them the ultimatum, and our heroes don't know what to do. RWBY, the leader, is especially stressed out.
Then nothing has changed! We're in the exact same place we were yesterday! Arguing over what to do while the kingdom waits to die.
No, RWBY. You're not arguing about what to do. This time, none of you have a clue what to do.
If Miss Hero, with all the answers, doesn't have an answer, then we have ours.
Whatever, she's upset. We can let that slide, right? She gets up from the table and runs off, and Yang follows. This was the precursor for this interaction. So RWBY's feeling down in an earlier round, and Yang tries to lighten the mood.
You know, that giant hound kicked us around like we were nothing, but Blake said you and the Chinese managed to take it down. Still having to one-up your big sis, huh?
I like it. It works. Seems very big sister to me. Next, RWBY decides to let Yang in on what's been on her mind all day.
Did she tell you what it was?
Yeah.
You know what that means then.
I wouldn't worry about that.
That's what happened to Mom.
RWBY believes that Salem turned her mom into one of these.
Take the girl. Take the girl.
I really don't like how these writers write.
This is CNN breaking news.
Shocking, I know. Breaking news, right? I really don't like it. They seem to have a problem with making their characters feel real and conscious. Guys, RWBY knew from episode 1 that her mom went on a mission and died. She found out in Volume 3 that her mom was a silver-eyed warrior.
I think it was something about
silver eyes. That's an extremely rare trait.
So?
You're special, RWBY. You're special the same way your mom was.
And? She doesn't give a damn. How do I know that? Well, listen to what she tells Maria in Volume 6.
Let's start with what you do know. Tell me.
Silver-eyed people are supposed to be legendary warriors. Or something.
Or something? She's not even sure of what Crow told her back in Volume 3. Imagine learning something like this about your mom and not asking questions. She's uncaring and it's not believable. It doesn't ring true. So because of the way this was written, we have no choice but to believe that RWBY doesn't care about her mom being a silver-eyed warrior.
I have no more questions.
In Volume 4, RWBY learns that Salem was after her because of her silver eyes.
Why was he after me?
I told you having silver eyes is a rare trait. And the fact that you're someone that was able to use them seems to have upset some very powerful people.
This was the perfect time for the writers to have RWBY wonder if Salem was linked to her mother's disappearance, but they chose to make her oblivious.
What?
She finds out in Volume 6 that Salem was killing off silver-eyed warriors.
How could such powerful bloodlines be so rare? Something was actively seeking to destroy them.
Salem.
This was the perfect time for the writers to have RWBY wonder if Salem was linked to her mother's death, but once again, they chose to make her oblivious.
What?
Guys, up until Volume 7, the writers presented this character as uncaring and oblivious when it came to her mother and her status as a silver-eyed warrior. This was only the second time in the entire show she talked to anyone about her mom. What's so special about the topic now? Why is she invested now? She was oblivious before, but now she knows without a shadow of a doubt that Salem clapped her mom? What was it that made her believe her mom was turned into a grimdog? Well, you see, Salem said she talked to Summer once.
Your mother
said those words to me.
And this guy happened to have silver eyes. That's it. That is it.
When I saw its eyes, I knew. Salem used to kill people with silver eyes. Why would that change unless when she met Mom, she learned she could do something new?
These writing choices are so frustrating. The Summer Rose angle feels like it came out of nowhere, but it didn't have to. If they wanted the mystery of Summer's death to impact the characters in a way that would resonate with the viewer, they should have been laying the groundwork. They had every opportunity to build up to this moment, and for whatever reason, they chose not to. They chose to make RWBY ignorant while Yang was calling another woman Mom.
Mom. Yang.
My mom left me. RWBY's mom left too.
If you found yourself not caring about this moment, that is the reason why. So after Yang cries over the mom she recently remembered she had, RWBY continues to speak her mind.
We shouldn't lie to ourselves. I wasted our time getting Amity up, thinking help would come, but it didn't. I was being childish.
I appreciate this bit from the writers. She's actually critical of herself. After an entire volume of bad leadership, it's good to see her acknowledge her shortcomings. It makes her a more likable character. RWBY tells Yang that her plan didn't work and that she wasted their time. She's talking to Yang, the same character that said this.
RWBY, when we came here, we said we'd follow your lead, but things haven't exactly worked out.
Wait, stop. I know what you're thinking. Oh yeah, I forgot about this moment. You hardly remember it because it goes nowhere. Yang's words should have been ringing in RWBY's head the whole volume. How could you write this scene and not have RWBY bring up the fact that Yang questioned her leadership back in chapter 1? How? RWBY should have said, "You're right, Yang. I've been a bad leader. I've been screwing up big time." Something. The scene would instantly have more weight. Perhaps Yang would have to address whether she was right or wrong to call out her sister in that moment. You're touching on their relationship, their current dynamic. Maybe RWBY would have to reflect on her Volume 7 mistakes. Maybe RWBY would ask for someone else to lead. Good character developments. There's different ways you can take it, but not addressing it at all is just silly. It makes the volume feel less cohesive. Unfortunately, my confusion does not stop there. RWBY's plan was to get Amity up and running so they could get a warning out and call for help. She accomplished her goal, but no one came. Yang told her in chapter 1 there was a chance no one would come.
It's pointless. And even if you got the message out, there's no guarantee help would come.
RWBY said it was worth the trouble because they had to get a warning out.
It's not pointless. Atlas is only Salem's current target. She's not hiding anymore, and once she's done here, she'll move on to the rest of Remnant. We need to warn them!
So what's the issue here? Why does she believe it was a waste of time? It's contradictory. The writing here, I just don't understand. Next, Yang tries to make her feel better when she talks of optimism and taking risk.
Blind optimism isn't great, but no optimism means we've already lost. We need to take risks.
But mine didn't work.
It still got a warning out. RWBY, they're not called sure things. And in case you didn't notice, my plan for Mantle didn't work either.
What did she just say?
And in case you didn't notice, my plan for Mantle didn't work either.
What the frack is Yang even talking about? She had no plan.
We need to get out there and do what we can for Mantle. Do what you gotta do. I'm going out there to see what I could do.
Her group wanted to help the folks on the ground immediately, and that's what she did.
Where's this group coming in from?
That would be Sector 7.
You cleared 7 already? That's great!
They helped. What was that line?
But we got Oscar back. And did a lot more that was never in the plan.
There was no plan. Stop saying that.
Mom took a risk the day she left. I don't think it went the way she wanted it to. But she's still my hero.
Aww, you hear that, RWBY? You can still be Yang's hero. How sweet. If only the audience cared. If only the moment mattered. As I stated earlier, most of you guys forgot this scene even happened. But it's not your fault. The scene comes and goes, and nothing really comes of it. Here's a question. What is the purpose of this talk? Was it to push the plot forward? No. Did this develop their relationship? No. Was it for the sake of the characters? RWBY feels she's letting everyone down, and her plans aren't working, according to her.
We need to take risks.
But mine didn't work.
I mean, she's really not trying to hear what Yang has to say. Is this something RWBY will have to work through? Will they have to rebuild her confidence? Will this be a major development for the character?
5 minutes later.
That's actually a risk we haven't considered.
Less than 5 minutes later, in real time, RWBY's got another plan, another risk, and she's smiling. I repeat, in less than 5 minutes. Nothing that happens between this and this would change how RWBY feels about her crappy leadership. Unless you think RWBY learning that trust is a risk matters.
I think after everything that's happened here, we understand.
Trust is a risk.
You're right, Weiss. I am amazing. I am a great leader. Fuck Vexed. Is it any wonder no one really cares about this moment? I mean, seriously. You know, it's interactions like this that make folks believe that these writers pander to the base. They insert these scenes not because they inform the character or the story. They do it because they believe that's what the fans want to see. See guys, RWBY and Yang are talking. Isn't that a great moment? No, it's not, because you could remove the scene and few would notice.
You know what that means then.
I wouldn't worry about that.
That's what happened to Mom.
The only thing you can really hold on to is the fact that they finally talked about Summer. But again, the way they've been writing these characters undercuts that. I was really looking forward to these two having a chat alone for the first time in years, but I have to say, it's left much to be desired. Still better than the Blake and RWBY talk though. That thing was lifeless. So that was my breakdown of this scene, guys. What are your thoughts? Let me know in the comments below. Is there a moment from Volume 8 that I haven't addressed yet? Let me know. Later, guys.